On Sunday, January 24th, 2021, the Ministry of Health and Wellness received confirmation from the Caribbean Public Health Agency, CAHPA, of 5 cases of SARS-CoV-2 British variant diagnosed in country. 2 of the cases are British nationals who were diagnosed on December 17th and December 23rd, 2020. The other 3 cases are St. Lucia nationals from Denry, Miku, and Babano districts, and they were also diagnosed in December 2020. All 5 cases have since made a full recovery from the COVID-19 virus. On December 14th, 2020, the United Kingdom Public Health Agency reported a variant of SARS-CoV. The identified strain had been in circulation from September 20th, 2020 within the United Kingdom. The virus has since been detected in Denmark, Netherlands, Belgium, and Australia, but the risk of importation into the Caribbean and the rest of the world was rated as high due to incoming travel from the United Kingdom and Europe. Cases of this new strain have since been confirmed in several Caribbean islands, including Trinidad and Tobago and Jamaica. It is known and expected that all viruses constantly change over time. As such, it had been anticipated that this would also obtain with the COVID-19 virus. Studies conducted in the United Kingdom on this new variant of the virus suggest that it increases the rate at which the virus spread. This is estimated as increasing as much as up to 70%. The United Kingdom has noted increased levels of transmission and spread in the areas where the variant SARS-CoV-2 strain has been found. However, there is no evidence at this point of more severe cases associated with the new variant or reducing the effectiveness of the COVID-19 vaccine. The European Centers of Disease Control and Prevention has confirmed the following. There are no reports of worse clinical outcomes. The level of mortality remains the same. The effect on the population groups affected remains the same. On Monday, December 21st, 2020, the Caribbean Public Health Agency hosted an emergency meeting with PAHO, WHO, OECS, and the chief medical officers of the region to discuss the new risk by this new variant. It was further confirmed that the COVID-19 PCR testing being done in countries remains the gold standard to ensure accurate diagnosis within the mutations, and the vaccine approved by the Food and Drug Administration remains as relevant. The recommendations made are in relation to the strict adherence to the current regional and national guidelines on COVID-19 prevention and control. These include the limitations on social gatherings, the maintenance of physical distancing measures, hand hygiene and infection prevention and control measures, the mandatory use of face masks in public, and strict adherence to protocols within the tourism sector, and the quarantine for all returning nationals. CAHPA has also requested that positive cases with high viral loads be sent to their labs for gene sequencing for surveillance of this new strain of the virus in our region. St. Lucia has complied with these recommendations. CAHPA is the regional reference lab with the capacity to perform gene sequencing for the region. So it has allowed countries to set an allocation of 10 samples per week, which meet the requirements for gene sequencing. This new situation further emphasizes the need for strict adherence to all protocols recommended thus far and to ensure increased vigilance at all levels where risk has been identified. The Ministry of Health and Wellness will continue monitoring the situation, and recommendations will be made as needed, guided by the science, to reduce the impact of COVID-19 on our population. We continue to monitor both the global and regional situation as we assess our risks and make recommendations. We also continue to monitor closely and use best practices implemented as we strengthen the existing national protocols. The Ministry of Health and Wellness will continue providing updates as new information becomes available.